Now let's do few examples on frequency distribution.
The first example says that there are marks which are obtained by 25 students in a class. So we have been given this series which you can see here. Then we have been told to arrange the above data in form of frequency distribution, taking the class interval 20 to 29, 30 to 39, 40 to 49, so on and so forth. Okay, see here we can convert the frequency the given data into frequency distribution. So here we have been given inclusive series. Okay, so first thing is we have been just given three class intervals, so we have to find out the remaining ones. So first see what is the highest marks here. The highest mark is 69, so my class interval would be 50 to 59 and 60 to 69. That would be my class intervals. Next we can use tally bar. Okay, and using the tally bar we can find out the frequency for this particular class intervals which we have been given. So what I'll do is we'll start with the tally bar. Now 22 will be between the class interval 20 to 29. So I'll put one tally bar out here. 28 would be the next tally bar, which would be in the same class interval 20 to 29. Then 30 will come in this particular class interval. Then we have 32, so it will come here. Again 35 will come in this class interval. And then we have 37. So that's the tally bar out here. Four of them. Next is 40. So 40 will come in the group or the class interval 40 to 49. 43 will also be coming in this class interval. Again one more mark for 41. Then we have 44. Okay. Now after the four tally bars are finished, you remember the fifth one has to be in a marked in a diagonal manner or as a slash. Right, so that's what I have done for the fifth one. Fine, then we have again 45 being given, so that would be the next tally bar which I have put here. Then 48 and then again 49. Next comes is your 52. So 52 will come here. 53, the next one will come here. Again 54 would come here. Then comes 56. Now four tally bars are over, so the fifth one will come as a slash or as a would be put in a diagonal manner. So that's 56 out here. Then we have been given 58, so we'll put one new tally bar out here. Now for 60, I will use the class interval 60 to 69. I'll mark second tally bar for 62, third one for 65. Okay, fourth one is for 68, and then the fifth one which was a slash which will come for 69. Now I will write down the frequency. So here the number of tally bars are 2, so I'll write down 2. Here we have 1 2 3 4, so I'll write down 4. Now here we have 5 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, that's 8. Then here we have 5 plus 1 which is 6. Here we have 5. Now if you total this up, so that's coming to 20. See, 8 plus 2 is 10, plus 4 is 14, plus 6 is 20, plus 5 is 25. Now remember that if this frequency doesn't total up to the number of students, then something is wrong. So in exam, this is the best way to check. Now we are being done with the part A of the question. Let's move to the second part. So in the second part, we have been asked to form the less than cumulative frequency distribution using the tally bar and inclusive series. Now we already formed the tally bar out here and the inclusive series. So I'll take this frequency from here and utilize it in my second question, okay, or the second part of the question which we are doing. Okay, so here the class interval was this, which is we have discussed in the earlier part. Then we will form the exclusive group because we have been asked to do so. Okay, so to form the cumulative frequency distribution that is less than of the given distribution, we will have to form the exclusive group. And for exclusive group, what I'll do is I will subtract 0.5 from the class interval, that is I'll subtract 0.5 from the lower class limit and add that 0.5 to the upper class limit. So that's the exclusive group which is formed. Now, because I have to find out the cumulative frequency distribution less than, I have to show that particular table. So here we will say less than 29.5. That's the exclusive group which we form. So we are taking these values and writing down less than 29.5, less than 39.5, so on and so forth. And frequency we have taken from part 1 of the question or part A of the example. So here we have the table ready, which is the cumulative frequency distribution less than. Okay, now let's move to example number 2. Now here in this example we have been given the table and we have been asked to present the table in more than series. So here I already have a normal continuous variable format table given to me. Okay, now we have to form a more than series. How do I do that? See, when it comes to class interval, it would be more than 10, so you will write the lower class limit more than 10, more than 20, more than 80. But the question is, how do I distribute the frequency? So it's a very simple way to do that. First, total the entire frequency. So the total comes to 86. Now write down 86. So more than 10, the cumulative frequency is 86. Now for 20, what you will do, you will take 86 minus the frequency of the class interval 10 to 20, and then you will get 74. The same thing you will do for all the class intervals. Okay, so this is how prepare the table in the form of more than series.